It's not by Gigi.
I love it.
Crossroads Hope Academy is a 24-bed.
It's a 24-bed foster home.
I can't do it.
For hard-to-place kids.
For hard-to-place boys ages 12 through 17.
Crossroads has two vocational programs, one culinary and one shop.
We have our own charter school on 20 acres on Babcock Ranch. We've noticed a trend over the last couple of years. We started getting an excess of 65 referrals a month. I had several months where we received over 100 referrals. Before that, we averaged for the first 6 years 45 referrals a month. That is the reason we're planning on building a new facility so that we can help more foster kids. We have been very successful with the boys that we've taken, and we have a state name now. That also contributed to getting more referrals. About 2 years ago, a piece of federal legislation passed, and it really rocked foster care, specifically the way group homes are operated. And for that reason, many group homes in Florida began closing. That's another reason we think we started receiving heavy referrals. Either way, we're stepping up to the plate, and we're planning on working with more boys. We learned very quickly what works and what doesn't work. If you look at national numbers on foster kids, 1 in 4 will be homeless by the age of 22, 1 in 5 will be incarcerated. 80% of the adult correction system is filled with former foster kids. We, on the other hand, out of 30 boys who have turned 18 with us, have had only 1 incarcerated, 1 that's homeless. We have 7 out of 30 that are in college or in vocational programming. And the rest have jobs and are working on high school diplomas and that sort of thing. 2% of foster kids ever go to the university. Those national statistics are based on kids who've been on average to 3 foster placements. My boys on average have been to 14 foster placements. We're working with more difficult kids and we're having better success rates with them. We are seeing this as an opportunity, one, to get a bigger voice in the state as how foster kids are affected by legislation, and two, be able to provide more opportunities for our boys here locally. With a bigger campus with more resources, we'll be able to add vocational components, work on workforce readiness, plus increase our ability in our school to educate. We're not just thinking about what can happen at the moment, but what can happen in the future, not only locally, but potentially statewide and even nationally.
Where are we?
This is the 10-acre piece of property right here. So it's lengthwise. It's a rectangular piece of property. And you can see we're in the middle of nowhere.
It's exactly 6 miles, but as a crow flies, it's probably only 3 miles straight through the woods.
So we don't have a site plan yet. But the thinking would be that the building would be on this side because we'll have to have a retention pond. We're on a paved road, so that's nice. The volunteers will really like that. The property we're on now is 20-acre property, but we're only on about 7 of that. So it would seem that this should be plenty of property.
There's so much unused land around here that if we wanted to expand, it's probably a possibility. Right now, the plan is to build a living facility that's big enough to have rec rooms within it. It's a 7,000 square foot, 24 bedroom facility with two bathrooms and two different recreation rooms and a laundry room and a few offices as well. And eventually we would build a cafeteria here as well, but in the short term, since they're gonna go to school on the other side, we would do meals over there. The idea would be that these guys would go over there for schooling for part of the day, and then also they would go into town to work in vocational fields, to get apprenticed in vocational fields, masonry and electrician, plumbing, stuff like that.
How old are you?
12.
How long have you been here?
For 3 months.
How do you like it? You can answer honestly.
Good so far.
What do you like about it?
I like how, you know, we get to go off campus and we get allowance every weekend.
How does that work? How does the allowance work?
Well, you have to do your chores every day.
Do you have any idea what you want to do when you grow up?
Go to the NFL.
As a what?
Running back or a wide receiver.
I'm going to go to college to be a mechanic. And I'm gonna have a side job as a fast food restaurant.
My plans for the future are hopefully to play football and go to college.
I wanna work with animals, so I wanna work in like a vet clinics.
How do you like it here?
It's pretty great. I'm 15 and I'm trying to become a better young man.